They speak about how the new Christians were to live in community with each other. This text isn't just talking about a relationship between two people, a husband and a wife. The passage is talking about all of our relationships in the body of Christ. The Apostle Paul was one of the leaders of the early church when he wrote this letter, and he was concerned for the young congregation in this busy metropolitan area. The community was made up of men and women not unlike yourselves, very confident and self-assured. The people thought they knew how things ought to be run. They'd been in relationships with one another before, long enough to begin to find out things about each other that they didn't like. Now you two have taken the time to find out what it means to build a relationship with each other. You've shared with one another what some of the things are that you love about the other. When I asked you each to list 10 things that you loved about the other person, you both went beyond the 10. You broke the rules. And frankly, just looking at one another in that exercise, I think it just kept bringing more and more things to mind of what you loved about each other. You've shared your dreams and your wishes for the other person and for your marriage going forward, and that's an excellent foundation. So you probably feel over time you've learned a lot about each other. And while Paul writes these words to the people of his time and in his context, he does indeed write to all of us in the church today, and in a very real sense to the two of you in this moment.
I promise that wherever you may go, wherever life may lead you, with all my heart I'll be there too. And from this moment on, I want you to know I let nothing come between us, and I will love the ones you love. Now honor all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything. When he created you, I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking about harmonize in perfect tune. One can't move without the other. They just have to be together. And that is why I know it's true. You're for me and I'm for you. 'Cause my world just can't be right without you in my
hand. It's yours to hold. I give myself to you.
Here's my heart. Please make it yours. I give my love to you.
We are two becoming one. Here I am, here's all of me. You have all that once was mine.
And here's my promise, I'm yours to hold. I'll stay here by your side.
We are two becoming one.
We are two becoming one. May what he's joined be not undone. May our love put Christ on display. When we're weak and when we're strong, when it's hard to carry on, oh God, we want your love on display.
We are two becoming one. Here's my life, I lay it down. I give up myself for you.
And here's my will, I submit to you. I will follow where you lead.
We are two becoming one. Becoming one, may what he's joined be not undone. May our love for Christ on display.